Hello, I am Anshul Shah from Department of Criminology, Raksha Shakti University, Ahmedabad, Gujarat. The title of the module is Electronic Commerce. The objectives of the modules are to understand the electronic commerce as a form of commerce in the era of technological advancements. The second objective is to understand different types of e-commerce. The third objective is to understand the evolution of internet which made e-commerce possible. To understand the barriers of e-commerce in developing countries as well as to understand basic functions which is must with electronic commerce. The prerequisites terms for the modules are internet, payments gateways and online transactions. The learning outcomes are, after reading the module, one will be able to understand the basics and meaning of electronic commerce, general type of e-commerce which depends on buyers and customers, evolution of internet with the idea of doing business online, barriers of developing countries in developing e-commerce, the privacy concerns while doing business online, and minimum functions which is required to safeguard from online fraud. Keywords for the modules are e-commerce, developing countries and barriers, internet forms of e-commerce with increasing internet usage among many individuals and variety of mediums for social connectivity, the business nowadays is also taking similar route. Electronic commerce, also called as e-commerce, is considered a process by which business sell products on the electronic medium, and vis-a-vis the customer can buy the products from the medium. E-commerce is basically electronic medium for providing opportunities for both the sellers and buyers to advertise a product and in turn sell the product, whereas for the consumer it is the opportunity to select from variety of offers and products and choose as per the need. Electronic commerce started in 1990 and after that it has increased with rapid rate, capitalizing the market from clothes to furniture, food and many items which were presumed to be only market-based products now is available online as well. Now there is a necessity of presence of a company on the website portal and in online form to expand the business and reach new clients. Amazon and Flipkart are two examples of companies which operate the online business for mass of people. The website offer wide variety of products from jewelry to household products from which consumers can select and choose whatever they find appropriate. Consumers also have option to select the venue where the products are to be delivered and payment gateways to pay for the product according to their preferred option. They can even choose the option to pay after they have received the product, popularly called as cash on delivery. Online retailing has been important channel or business model for many firms. As the online retailing market becomes competitive, online sellers have shifted their attention from inducing consumers to adopt their online channels to motivate consumers to purchase repeatedly through these channels. A study by Manspring and Bain and Company show that average customer must shop 4 times at an online store before the shop can get profit from that customer. It is thus important for online sellers to understand why buyers are willing to make repeat purchases through their stores. Consumer behavior is often depicted as goal-directed. There are two major streams of study on online shopping goals. Some studies consider obtaining values, example utilitarian and hedonic values, as shopping goals and examine their effects on repeat purchase intention, also called as value intention linkage. Other investigate the effects of online shopping benefits on repeat purchase intention, also known as benefit intention linkage. It is important to understand how risk may influence the repeat purchase intention of consumers in online context. The benefits of e-commerce include its around-the-clock availability, the speed of access, and the wide availability of goods and services for consumers, easy accessibility, and international reach. Its perceived downsides include sometimes limited customer service, consumers not being able to see or touch a product prior to purchase, and then sometimes unnecessary wait time for product shipping. E-commerce is conducted using variety of applications such as email, online, catalogs, EDI, file transfer protocol, and web services. This includes business-to-business activities and outreach such as small unsolicited ads, usually viewed as spam to consumers and other business prospects, as well as send out e-letters to subscribers. Many companies now to entice consumer directly online using tools as digital coupons, marketing and targeting advertisements. Now, general types of e-commerce. First type of e-commerce is B2C type of e-commerce, which is referred to as business to customer type of business, where business people sells their product directly to consumer. Consumer has variety of product to choose from for particular web portals of the business person. Second among this is B2B, which is also known as business to business form of e-commerce, where one company or business sell their products or via internet to business. Companies also usually have internet presence. Example, company called GoDaddy, who primarily sells domains, name sites and host services to other businesses. Third is C2B form of commerce, which is called as consumer to business. We sell products directly to the business, where customers give option on the product which are to be sold, what are they expecting of the needs, and what are, and lastly is the C2C form of commerce, which are customers selling the products to another prospective clients. The products could be based out of need of the consumer or who frequently visit the website, or could be products which are no longer in use of the individual who owns it and want to sell it to someone else who are in dire need of it. Example of that is OLX and Quikr, which website which act as a platform to sell products which are no longer used by individuals and want to sell it to others. Now next is evolution of internet for e-commerce. Advancement of information and communication technologies has enabled these changes, which has got the term commerce in the domain of e-commerce. This is because of the factors like globalization, which has made the world a smaller place and helped in building networks among organizations. According to Atkins, e-commerce has been possible due to increase in proper infrastructure in the cyberspace, often called as cyber infrastructure, which refers to increase in capacity of network to hold transactions, connectivity between different networks, and handling of large amount of data, with processing all this data for better customized results for the customers. Earlier barrier was low trust of customer on paying the amount online via online payment gateways, which has been addressed effectively lately. The climate of collaboration between academia, government and private players was essential role players in development of internet, which gave the huge boost to present e-commerce business. The development of internet was not only because of the commercial interest to pursue profits, with the role of government is to pursue something which is of national importance and is in interest of people, and role of academic is to work towards advancing the frontiers of science. On behalf of national defense, the initial investment was made to extrapolate the importance of internet. Internet was first developed by Tim Berners-Lee, researcher at CERN, along with Mark Anderson, young computer scientist at NCSA, with hypertext markup language for documents, which were meant to send to thousands of investigators working for CERN to develop a particle accelerator. This gave birth to www between 1989 to 1991, along with hypertext markup language, which is called as HTML. The application which could read the documents in language was also developed, which was called Mosaic. According to Reed, Mosaic was turned into commercial product called Netscape for public usage. Anderson and Eric Bina at NCSA, which was released to public in 1993. Netscape turned out to be first important web browser in B2C type of e-commerce. Nowadays, a new browsers like Google Chrome, along with Microsoft Internet Explorer and Safari for Apple, an open source consortium Mozilla Firefox is available in market. Physicists start using web for its big science complex things, but web in itself grew around other forms of enterprises which were mainly commercial in nature. Internet has been important in changing landscape of commerce like Google, which grew out of NSF funded digital libraries initiative, is now a big research engine, earns its revenues from advertising. According to Hofker and Murphy, Google model profoundly changed the world of advertising, ushering in era of clickstream revenues and data analytics. The Google phenomena illustrates one of these trends, a transformation catalyzed by aggregation and management of large-scale data resources. The beauty of Google is its simplicity. It collects data from the users of the web and sells those data in different forms to users of the web. The magic of Google lies in sophistication of its infrastructure, both with respect to collecting and redistributing data and operating at very large scale. That sophistication raises concern as well, including those of personal privacy. The question of what Google knows about individual and what is willing to do with such information has been at heart of many criticisms of the company and its practices. Now we'll discuss about barriers of e-commerce in developing countries. Research shows that slow internet diffusion and connectivity in the developing countries has led to low IT business market in such markets, which are measured by performance and productivity. The slow internet diffusion could be because of the lack of infrastructural facilities as well as market factors which are important to regulate the electronic commerce. Another reason is lack of availability of credit cards in developing countries like India and Russia, which researches show that due to unavailability of credit cards has hampered B2C business in developing countries. In India, maximum transaction was cash based and many of the finance facilities are underdeveloped. But recently, measures are taken to motivate people to do online transaction and infrastructure is getting improved to avail internet services to all, and better ways are adopted to educate people to use internet and applications which make many tasks possible with single click of mouse button. Internet is also less attractive for economies which are more dependent on traditional economic sectors like agriculture, which could be inferred from researches which points out that cost savings from e-commerce as a percentage of total input cost is only 2% for firms in a traditional sector such as coal, compared to 40% in electronic components, which refers to the total cost savings of product which is based out of traditional sector is low if sold online, whereas for electronic products which the cost saving for the product is high if sold online. Another problem is that of logistics issue, which is important for delivering products to customers, and final bandwidth availability is low in developing countries. Low bandwidth refers to increasing in time to transfer the data, which makes internet surfing and buying product a slow process. In India, business is more regulated by trust and personal relationship, and anonymous online transaction and relation often threaten the interpersonal networks. Preference is always given to personal face-to-face communications over emails and any virtual networks, and always importance is given to established relationship and relationship which are tested with time rather than internet's interpersonal efficiency also work against e-commerce. Even countries have weak formal institution has customers who have less interest and willingness to shop online or use credential to do online shopping. Few things like legal validity of digital and electronic signatures are also not considered important. In some of the states and even few countries, impose taxes on information and communication technologies, which makes it very difficult to do business online. A survey conducted among Brazilian consumers indicated that low e-commerce adoption rate was related to government regulations such as concern about privacy and security, lack of business laws for e-commerce, inadequate legal protection for internet purchases, and concern over internet taxation. Cognitive factors or cognitive barrier is one of the factors which hinders growth of e-commerce in developing countries. These barriers are related to mental maps of individuals and organizational decision maker. Many effects such as confidence inadequate awareness, knowledge and skills serve as cognitive feedbacks to continue electronic medium or not. Consumer lack of awareness and knowledge about benefits of e-commerce and the lack of confidence in service providers have also hindered the scope of business with e-commerce. Considering the fact that most software and human computer interfaces with content on the web are in English language, general and computer literacy and a lack of English language skills is important. Cognitive behavior which hinders the individual to order online because one is not aware of how to use internet and computer to order anything or conduct businesses functions which are required in electronic commerce. The following section deals with minimum requirement of functions which electronic commerce solution should fulfill. The rise of e-commerce forces IT personnel to move beyond infrastructural design and maintenance and consider numerous customer facing aspects such as consumer data privacy and security. When developing IT systems and applications to accommodate e-commerce activities, data governance related regulatory compliances, data and information protection protocols must be considered. First of all, security. First of the requirement is the maintaining security of the clients. The security components should at least include a secure socket layer, also called as SSL, for secure data transfer, and with it 128-bit or higher encryption of data, stored data. When numbers of credit card are to be stored, with addition to it, merchant certificates and comparable security protocol like SCT is to be maintained security. For frequent abusers, velocity checking of credit card numbers is important to cut down number of forgery attempts and those who are using credit card of others. And finally, message encryption ensures that price, quantity and item does not change after the transaction is made, which is important to maintain integrity of the transaction. The second is user authorization and authentication. In order to recognize and identify a customer, user ID and password are most important means to identify. But these are often enhanced by digital signatures and certificates for the merchant and for buyer security protocols. Customer database. Customer is most important part of e-commerce business, for which taking care of preferences of the customer is one of the important things which is to be considered. Data management of the customer is a much required need, which can be done by customizing and personalizing the buyer experience by showing items or discounts based on the buyer's profile. An account for customer created by buyer is important to maintain data accuracy for customer, so that customer is well aware of the transactions made by them and plus could modify all the purchases made by them and well keep record of shopping done by them. With addition to it, customer data stored online could help buyer in registering at the site and personalize their sale, plus system is set up to save transaction details, which is done to avoid entering debit card details multiple times with each transaction. Now another is order capture and management. Order capture software supports digital, physical and subscription goods. The software should ensure proper instruction to carry booking orders with handling and delivering physical goods and manage electronic download for digital goods like electronic books. It should calculate the tax which is appropriate to order. Along with it, shipping charges which is likely to be cost of delivery are to be sent to fulfillment center via messages so that delivery could be managed. With it, keeping records of the transaction, allowing customers the use of shopping cards and to real time in transaction records with audit trial reports for merchants to process their sale records and products sold. Another is security payment processing. Payment processing can be taken in form of net banking, credit or debit card or cash on delivery, and e-wallets and e-commerce solutions should be offered on such options in a secure way so that information is not leaked without the consent of customers, and to avoid misuse of card or wallet in another fake transaction. It should allow pay-per-view subscription as well as trial and grace period so that offers could be used according to need and paying capacity of the customer. The another point is optimal customer service. Customer wants both security and service, for which UltraCare is provided to cater services round the clock for 24 hours and 365 days. Buyer want online access to their order status and profile and additional required authorization without pre-established monetary thresholds are exceeded. With evidence of cash on delivery, it becomes very popular among people from middle class and poor people who still consider paying after a product has reached them. Fulfillment management. After order is placed for physical goods, the good must be shipped. The e-commerce solution should integrate shipping charges and provide it to the buyer before the purchase is made. Ideally, the electronic commerce solution should communicate with shipping companies to update a buyer's order status and communicate the order status to existing back office systems and back to customers. Other is traffic generation. A good electronic commerce solution utilizes traffic generation programs, which may include distribution of digital coupons, buyer customer site, customized site and contents, and consumer profile discounts. A merchant site cannot be successful unless traffic is driven to it. Virtual communities, multiple merchants supporting a common theme, attract buyers and buyers interested in particular topic on industry. Now the conclusion of the module. The article on e-commerce was to help us to understand the introduction of electronic commerce, which is another form of doing business and is done online with the help of internet. The present times with onset of better internet connectivity has made the situation possible with describing different forms of electronic commerce, which are categorized into three parts depending on the way business is handled. With the evolution of internet and other structural integrities are also important in taking commerce to a whole new level. With it, some barriers are considered mostly in the developing countries where internet services have recently been uprising, and barriers are discussed which makes doing commerce online a much difficult task. With it, factors which are important in better experiences of e-commerce is described so that experience which customer feel is different from chaos, and ensuring better quality of products which are ordered and are going to be delivered. Thank you for listening to this module.